Welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. We are going, not to inventory, back to the Groundbreaker. This is a quest we picked up way back when, probably in the teens of episodes. Back when we first went to the Groundbreaker. So, quite a while ago. Wanda became a Captain Irian and the Delivery. That was a few episodes ago. Actually, two episodes? Maybe three ago. I think it was three. I think it was episode 100. We found him. He was being held captive by outlaws, and he needed saving, and we saved him. So we also come to this to find Trask. So I'm guessing, well, he's on the Groundbreaker. Guessing, or his wife's on the Groundbreaker anyway. If he's on the Groundbreaker, he's probably in the back bay somewhere, but we're supposed to find Rosanna. Rosanna! Rosanna! And this is Byzantium. This is Byzantium, and I have one thing to do back on, what do you call it? The caves on Edgewater. In Edgewater. Near Edgewater. So anyway, heading back to the Groundbreaker for now. Yeah. Am I already there? I will. I know I was on Scylla. I must have hit cancel.
Destination reached. The Groundbreaker.
I don't know why. Sometimes the controls are like not intuitive to me. Like I think enter should be down on the bottom. Just a personal, I guess, thing. And I don't know why I keep going into inventory. So we should be bringing Felix for that. Should I bring Ellie as well? I guess Felix and Ellie. With just a little science, you can tinker with your weapons and armor at a workbench, increasing the damage they will inflict or prevent. Indeed. You know, I haven't tinkered with armor, have I? I don't think I have. Well, you know, I have, but not recently. I've been obsessed with getting my hunting rifle ultra up to, like, super ultra. Okay, so where's this? I know she's that way. Rosanna! Standing over here or something?
Rizzo's purple berry fudge, a soft sour candy shell around a sweet purple berry flavored center. Suck it, chew it, you can do it.
I don't want to do it. She's in here? What is this? The bar? The Lost Hope, right. So she's hanging out in the Lost Hope, okay. Good.
This is Halcyon News. We interrupt your regularly scheduled.
Hi.
Do you mind? Trying to have a moment here.
Are you Rosanna Trask?
Yeah, I was called that once upon a day. You need something?
I'm looking for a guy by the name of Rufus Trask. I'm told he lived around here.
Rufus and I are no longer on speaking terms. I don't know where he is. And if I did, I wouldn't tell you.
I'm on the level. You can ask Jen Lay about me.
You're telling me you're on a first-name basis with Ms. Tennyson?
I'm not one of Harlow's thugs. You can trust me.
All right. I'm gonna take your word for it.
Good.
Rufus is hiding out in Emerald Vale.
Okay.
Got a few friends with him. That's as much as I know.
Good, because we need to head down there to kill some Manta Queens, too. I have a few more questions, though.
Please, just make it quick.
So you and Trask split up?
That's right. Our marriage contract expired some months ago. And seeing how he's technically an outlaw, I wouldn't renew even if I wanted to.
Your marriage contract expires? First I've heard of it. How much do you know about Harlow?
Precious little. He and Rufus worked together on the Groundbreaker some years back before he vanished. A few years later, Rufus gets a message from an old friend. Something about starting a revolution, something about getting rich. Abandoned his work and ran off that very day.
Harlow tells me that Trask betrayed him. Do you know anything about that?
Only that Rufus is in a bad way. He came to see me a little ways back. Said he had to go into hiding. Never asked why. He was here to collect his personals, complain about Harlow to me, and say goodbye. In that order.
Well, about to go play a little hide and seek then. He didn't tell you anything about Harlow?
No, and he was particular about that. Said I was better off not getting entangled in his mess. Little late for that, says I.
All right. Well, that's all I wanted to know.
Appreciate it. No offense meant. Just been a long day is all.
Sweet! My day just got a little brighter.
We still going after Trask, boss?
Something about this feels strange, Felix. Are you sure you trust this guy?
I know. Clyde comes off rougher than Mantisaur hide. He's a good guy, though. Just gotta get to know him.
I think you're being too forgiving of the guy who abandoned you without a word.
Yeah, I'm still not over that. You'd think a grown man would know how to let go of his past. But I guess I'm just not there yet.
Well, you were a kid. He was like an older brother. That's not something you get over. I'm not pricking this because I'm not sure if he actually is taking advantage of him, but it's very probable.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Walking out on a kid when you're pretty much the only friend he's got? That's pretty damn low.
Yeah.
Maybe we should go have a word with Trask. Get to the bottom of all this.
Alright, let's get going. Trask is hiding in Emerald Vale. He's gone into hiding. Yeah. All we found out is where he is and that she doesn't know anything. Alright. I can take a perk. Another perk. Science weapon damage. Now, what if this affects the actual, you know, science weapon effect? Like, the bubbling, levitating effect will be more effective as well, or just the damage itself. That's why I hesitate to take this right now. While moving, I don't really... I kind of stand still when I shoot, so... 3% damage, that can be helpful. Mm-hmm. I think I'm going to take this. Armor rating bonus, and especially the skill bonus. Are you kidding me? That. Area of effect, reduce, carrying capacity, movement speed. Yeah, I'm surprised they didn't have to. I mean, they kept it simple. I'm surprised that the tier 3 perks are just exactly the same. It's just one perk for, like, all of this. Normally, you know, successive amounts of perks cost more of whatever points you're, you know, putting towards it. Small amount of melee damage. Combat effect, you do increase damage. Melee damage return to his health. I don't deal in melee damage, so yeah. I'm gonna take this. Boop. And then skills. And skills, and then skills, and skills. What do I get at 60? Inhaler, healing effect for companions. I keep running across tough locks. I kind of tempted to put it into lockpicking. Wow. That's right, I get double from these people. Let's get intimidate. So do I have these effects? Because it's 83. Do I have up to this? Automechanical scramble chance and stuff. I want to be very persuasive. And I'm not going to always have her in the party. Or him in the party. Let's put into lockpick. Okay. Done. Alright, so solution vital. Howdy dowdy.
Hello. Junlei called up from engineering. Said I should let you buy medical supplies from our stores. Dr. Fenhill, I hope you're not here to harass any of our patients.
Harassing? Come on, I was trying to help Jesse.
You have a creative definition of helping.
Then it's lucky for us both that I've found gainful employment with someone who appreciates my ingenuity.
There you go.
Good luck with this one, Captain. Now, is there something I can help you with?
Yeah, more like, wish her good luck with me.
A better selection than you'll find on the promenade deck.
Yeah. I'm just trying to see if I can sell anything, if I do have anything to I think I got rid of everything. Yeah. I don't have anything to sell you, never mind then. But I need to talk to the lady here. Not you.
Pardon me.
Pardon you.
Well, well, Dr. Fenhill. It's not often I see you on this side of sickbay.
I make it a point not to get shot, and when I do, I can usually take care of the mess myself.
It'd be nice to have you in here patching people up, not just blowing them apart.
I respect what you're doing here, but you know I'm not ready to settle down. It's not you, it's me.
Have it your way, then. You always do.
But of course.
Now, about your friend here. Were I a gambling woman, I'd wager you're responsible for my mechanical safe return. I can't thank you enough.
Oh, return? I thought he was delivering you new ones. Well, you're welcome.
Keep hanging around and I'll begin to think you're here for me. What can I do for you?
Not a chance, lady.
You have yourself a day, then.
I gained 15,000 antibiotics, cream, adreno, immunosol. Okay. I think... Well, I don't need the cream. This is harmful status effect, minus 50%. Do we have something else that does that? Status effect. I think we do. Here, I already have... Oh, that's the cream. But then you gave me immunosol too, which is the same thing. Oh, the immunosol lasts 25 seconds. Screw it. I'll sell the immunosol. I don't like having so many different things. I'll keep the rest, though.
Something I can help you with? A better selection.
Yeah, better selection. It's only 5 more seconds. You know how quickly 5 seconds goes? Us as a medical bot. Okay. I didn't know they were, like, returned to her. I figured those were new ones she was ordering. I forgot all about it, obviously. Well, we don't have much to do. These two end up in a veil. Wait. Nope. One's Emerald Veil. I stand corrected. One's Emerald Veil and one's in Monarch. So let's go. Let's go to Emerald Veil and find Trask. Shut up. It's Rizzo's. I cannot resist the jingle. So yeah, I'm trying to finish up all this miscellaneous stuff on the other planets, and then we'll save Byzantium
Captain,
for last.
If you're looking for crew members Ellie or Felix, they're sharing a drink upstairs.
That's quick. They just came in here with me. Why would I be looking for them?
I'll pay you back for all of it. With interest.
Nice one. You must have had them quaking in their heels.
I mean, I wasn't really gonna do it. I just wanted to make them feel bad.
Pay you back with interest. I gotta remember that one.
Would have felt better if it had worked.
What worked?
Captain, I've been thinking.
Uh-oh.
Something about this Harlow guy isn't on the up and up.
Agreed.
Glad it's not just me. The way Harlow was leaning on his revolutionary bona fides, not to mention his knowing Felix back in the day, something about it feels off.
Don't worry, Ellie. I plan on keeping my eyes open.
Good. That makes two of us.
I might have some questions for you.
Something on your mind?
Or not.
We still going after Trask, boss?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, boss?
Yeah. Alright, let's go right now. Right frickin' now.
We are now in orbit above Edgewater, Captain.
Thank you, Ada. I'll take the scene too. That's interesting. I wonder if anyone else would have anything to say about Harlow. Didn't think that. I just naturally thought that because she came with us. Okay, quite far away. All the way over there. Huh. Is that up on a mountain then? By the botanical lab. It kind of looks like it's down somewhere. These are from way back. Surprised they're still here. Not decomposed by now. So wait. Yeah, we gotta get up there somehow. But it looks like it's down. Maybe it's underneath. Yeah, I see those guys over there.
Captain,
get.
Let's show him.
Can we do that again?
I know, it went so quick, didn't it? I'm sure we'll have another opportunity. I guess that was his leg. Oh, he must be in that cave. That's the cave, isn't it? Cool. Is that where we found the illustrated manual? I might drop these things because I couldn't carry anymore. Those were the days. Alright. So, Primal Nest? Is that a cave? Primal Nest. Well, it's not really safe to come down this way. Oop. I almost went down there anyway. Head first. I gotta find a safe way down. Still, I don't know if that's where the guy is, though. Is that a cave entrance there? Primal Behemoth. Primal Ravager.
Alright, here we go.
Oh my god, there's so many. Oh, they're running in. Whoa.
Just getting started.
You were getting started, huh? Oh. Pretty cool looking. There's the chests I saw. Or containers, whatever. Old Reliable. So it wasn't reliable enough. Maybe a little slow, but it will last forever. It's a heavy weapons damage. Some kind of rifle? No, like a, yeah, like a heavy machine gun. Ah, you. Okay, that's where it was. I'm like, I saw something and disappears. Like, nah, never mind. Yank! You don't need that. And he looks like he's inside a cave over here. There's a lot of dead people around here. I thought I saw an entrance to a cave. But that sounded spooky. I think I looked at this and thought this was an entrance to a cave. It's really just a flare. Oh well. So unless... In 227 meters, we go up and then back down. Unless it's just not showing up for me. Maybe he's in one of these houses. Never mind. Well, there's rocks in the way that way. How do we get up there? That's a good question. I don't see any kind of path or anything around. Aha! There we go. Looks likely. We got outlaws, but they're not showing up as hostiles. So since we plan on just talking the guy first, how about put our guns away? North Gulch. We haven't been here either. Yeah, I really didn't explore Emerald Vale that much. I just kind of did the quests I needed to do and then got the hell out. This is one of these terraformers here. I think the ship ended up going, landing here, maybe? River Hideout, Marauder Encampment. Come in peace. Mind if I have these tails? I collect them. and meat.
Got my sights on you.
Good to know.
Got my sights on you.
Oh, you too, huh? Rufus Trask?
I don't know who you are or why you're prowling around here, but I'm willing to make a guess. You're one of Harlow's gun hands, ain't you? He sent you after me.
That's right. Harlow said you betrayed him.
Yeah, of course he did. Thing is, you and I are at an impasse. Harlow wants me dead, and I've got no intention of dying.
Why did you betray Harlow?
How do I know that I can trust you?
If I wanted to kill you, we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Yeah, guess that's a fair point. Listen, I don't know what lies Harlow's dripped down your ear, but you'd be a fool to trust him. I never betrayed Harlow. Harlow betrayed all of us. The board's got him in their pocket, been paying him off for years. All the palaver about revolutions? It's a lie.
You can't be serious. I've known the guy for years.
Yeah, that's about how I reacted when I found out. That's the whole truth. Harlow's just another board asset. A two-bit mercenary wearing a dissident's clothes.
So you're saying Harlow's been using me?
Huh. You? Me? This kid you've got with you. His whole damn crew. Harlow's been using all of us. You're just the latest in a long string of lies.
I'm not gonna kill you, Trask, but I am gonna ask you for your ring.
You gonna tell Harlow I'm dead? May as well. I'm never going back to that life again. Here, take the ring. And for what it's worth, my gratitude.
Alright, take care.
Mulling it over, huh? I don't blame you. You need something else?
Yeah, I wanted to ask you a little bit more about Harlow.
Tell you what I can.
What was Harlow doing for the board?
Board sanctioned piracy. Harlow went after the ships the board wanted destroyed, capturing anybody the board wanted captured. If we captured you, we'd ransom you. Harlow liked to do the job himself. Gather up the captives on his own ship, vanish for a couple of days. Only that's not what happened. Harlow's been selling his captives off to the board. I don't know where they ended up. Re-education, Tartarus, maybe worse.
Why would the board buy off Harlow?
Because he's for sale. Anything the board can buy, the board will buy, and that includes loyalty. Harlow was a charismatic bastard, and he was ruthless.
Was?
With Harlow in their pocket, the board had an informant, a pirate, a smuggler, and a gang leader all rolled up into one odious excuse for a human being. Sounds like a deal to me.
Well, you're asking me to take you for your word. Show me some evidence.
Yeah, I've got proof. There's always a paper trail when the board's involved. I chanced upon some correspondence between Harlow and his employer. I don't know that it makes a difference. What was I to do with that evidence? Bring it in front of the board? There's no authority in Halcyon willing to take Harlow to task.
Temperament. Eh, you got proof, let's see it.
I hid my papers before Harlow chased me out. Back in the middle of the base, there's an old vent in a utility corridor. I stashed my evidence in that vent.
Huh. At Harlow's base? Alright, thanks.
You need something else?
By the way, I can't let you live now. Never mind.